Hello, I'm Paul. In this video, I want to share with you unique natural sounds generated by this acoustic grand piano made possible only by the fourth harmonic pedal. If you're watching this video, chances are you listen to and play classical, in the loosest sense of the word, piano. Chances are you own an upright acoustic grand piano or an electric piano. The electric piano is a wonderful invention. Quite apart from its affordability, it's easy to take to pieces for transport, light to carry, can be played with headphones in a family situation, doesn't need to be tuned, and can be recorded directly to your computer by line in. The one main thing an electric piano doesn't have is hammers and strings. What you hear when you play middle C on an electric piano is a digitally sampled recording of an acoustic piano's middle C. When you play middle C on an acoustic piano, you hear the strings tuned to C and also other strings right across the keyboard vibrating that share a sympathetic relationship to middle C. For example, the strings of octaves, thirds and fifths ring all by themselves immediately after you strike middle C. We don't hear them so clearly, they are in the background, but add an extra glow of resonance to middle C that give the acoustic piano its characteristic acoustic sound. Sympathetic resonance distinguishes the sound of an acoustic piano from an electric piano. There is software to add artificial overtones to digitally recorded music, but in this video, we'll be listening to the real thing. As you know, the piano has been around for centuries. You've probably listened to and played a modern grand piano, but if you watch this video to the end, you'll be amongst the first in the piano's history to ever really hear clearly the unique sound colours that for centuries have been hidden inside this amazing musical instrument. The reason we haven't heard this unique sound colour before is similar to the reason we can't look at the sun. Harmonic or sympathetic resonance can be thought of as solar flares, a beautiful phenomenon we can only see when the sun is eclipsed. So, to hear sympathetic resonance across the whole piano, we need to eclipse the notes struck by the finger. Why? Well, it's because of the dominance in volume of the resonance of the strings of this struck note. It just overpowers the sympathetic resonance that also occurs. Thankfully so, or the piano would be unplayable as a musical instrument if every string rang loudly across the whole range. In practical terms, to eclipse a note on the piano and to hear the musical solar flares, we need to strike the note and damper it straight away, like this. What we hear after the note is struck, then dampened, are all the strings glowing with a sympathetic relationship to that struck note. These strings haven't themselves been struck physically, as you could see, they rang all by themselves. So the next time you play the C minor chord in Beethoven's Pathetic Sonata, you will now be aware you hear C, E flat, G and C, but many more notes too ringing on their own that give that C minor chord its unique colour and make playing a good acoustic piano so enjoyable. The fourth harmonic pedal can do three main things, not just one thing, as is sometimes thought. The harmonic pedal has the sustain and the sostenuto built in, but the third thing is the special unique thing that gives the pedal its name. This third thing allows us to listen to musical solar flares. In resonance, half position, it allows the dampers to drop back onto the string or strings, as with the damper felt demonstration earlier. The instant the finger releases the key or keys, its hidden mechanism works so fast you can play staccato with sympathetic resonance for the first time ever. If we were to visualize this natural sound phenomena, we could think of our traditionally pedal piano as a landscape painting by John Constable. Constable's 18th century landscapes are painted with colours that all harmonise but are intentionally limited to a warm palette of colours. Brown tended to represent shadows from the sun. The harmonic pedal allows new colours from our piano to be heard for the first time. We could perhaps think of these new colours as being similar to the 19th century paintings of Georges Seurat, where, for the first time in art, violet and blue made pastel shades of colours in the shadows of the sun. But I promise you, you'd hear sounds from this piano produced naturally that no one has ever heard before. So, here goes. I'm going to play random chords. First, without pedal, so you can hear the notes of the chord. Then, replay and mute the volume on the chord strike on the strings and allow you to listen to the slightly amplified resonance that occurs naturally from all the other strings except the notes of the chord played. That's to say, what you're about to hear are the strings of this acoustic piano playing music on their own without physically being touched except by waves of sound.